On the Voice, you've been quite sure that the Voice would get up, the referendum would be successful. Those numbers have fallen in recent months. Do you think that the Yes campaign has bottomed out now? Now that the campaign is going to start, they really haven't kicked off the Yes campaign in terms of the advertising and so on?
No, Kieran, I think it could bottom out even further unless they begin to reassess the strategy and not just rely on football associations and large corporations to generate renewed interest. I think it will require more than that. I think they do now have to tackle the two core weaknesses that have been there since day one, being, of course, more detail and how will it improve the life and living conditions of so many of our disadvantaged Indigenous communities. Unless they tackle the detail issues, I think they're in real trouble. Queensland will vote no. Western Australia likely will vote no. And all it requires is one more state. Mind you, I think it's hard to find any of the other states voting no. So you'll probably, at this stage, get a majority vote of all Australians, ranging anything between 50 to 54%. But you may not get the three states you require if there's not fundamental re-examination of the meaning and content of the Voice, not just rely on the advocates.
Simon, the trend hasn't been encouraging to Yes campaigners.
No, it hasn't. But, you know, Kieran, I think we're coming up to a key inflection point in this debate. Essentially, in the next month, the debate about what the actual question that's being put to the Australian people will be settled, whether you agree with it or not. And that will be the basis upon which I think really conversations around workplaces, within families and out in the community will take place. That will be the ultimate question on which people are deciding yes or no. The Yes campaign tell us, and I think there's a lot of confidence that they are ready to have those person-by-person, community-by-community conversations. I agree with Peter. They're not going to win it through a glossy advertising campaign. They're not going to win it through corporate or sporting sponsorships, as important as they might be. They're going to win it in basically down at the pub or in the lounge room of ordinary Australians about pointing out what a dignified, respectful thing this is to simply listen to our Indigenous Australians about the problems that they face and come up with better solutions for the future.